We are a group of European civil service members who are extremely upset at having to appeal in this way to the highest authority in order to exercise our most basic right. We want the right to work in French.
This letter was sent to the new European Commission president before she was even sworn in. It's the work of a mysterious group of civil servants calling itself Carré Bleu, or Blue Square. Because of their jobs, they can't reveal their identities, but they prefer it that way anyway.
C'est pas facile de vouloir travailler en français sans passer pour la caricature du français qui veut imposer sa langue.
This member of the group has worked at the European Commission for 10 years, during which time he's noticed the French language being used progressively less and less.
La plupart du temps, ça se déroule que en anglais. Je me souviens, il y a de très nombreuses années, on avait préparé un projet de texte qui était rédigé en français. Très clairement, les cabinets nous ont fait passer le message « Pour cette fois, ça va, mais vous ne le faites plus jamais ». Et la hiérarchie, y compris francophone, aussi.
These working documents are available in English, French and German. So how do things go down in the press room?
Bonjour et bienvenue à notre réunion de midi. To start with, I will update you on the president's phone activity. President Juncker was moved and devastated by the news that Jacques Chirac has passed away.
Je voulais vous faire réagir sur cette lettre ouverte qui a été écrite à Ursula von der Leyen pour défendre l'usage du français. Est-ce que vous comprenez ces revendications?
Le français est la deuxième langue la plus utilisée dans la Commission. 144,514 1000 pages traduites vers le français en 2018. Le président Juncker a veillé à ce que le français soit restauré dans sa dignité.
An expression that caught the attention of Lorenzo Consoli, an Italian journalist who has long been defending the use of French at the European institutions. In Brussels for more than 30 years, Consoli remembers a time when press conferences here were quite different.
If someone asked a question in English, the spokesperson translated it into French and then answered in French. Boris Johnson, the current UK Prime Minister, who was a correspondent here for British newspapers, he asked his questions in French. He had an extraordinary accent, but he asked his questions in French.
In its letter, Carré Bleu also complains about management pushing for commissioned civil servants to speak English, even in the European Parliament, where an army of interpreters is on hand to translate between all of the EU's 24 official languages. We went to check what languages were spoken during MEP's recent confirmation hearings for future commissioners. First up, the Belgian Didier Reynders.
Nous préservons notre diversité. We believe that we must project our value.
En ik denk dat ook voor de migratie betreft.
Passed with flying colours. You could not say the same for Janusz Wojciechowski, Poland's pick to be agriculture commissioner.
If I will be the commissioner, I will implement the proposal.
After hearing some very vague and repetitive answers, the MEPs call the candidate back for a second interview. He changes tack.
And now I'd like to speak my mother tongue Polish. Rolnictwo europejskie musi być konkurencyjne.
Jurek Kuczkiewicz, a Polish-Belgian journalist, says it was like watching a completely different candidate when Wojciechowski switched to Polish.
He no longer came across as completely incompetent like he did during the first interview, even though everyone knows, even his political adversaries, that he's someone who knows about farming. By speaking Polish, he was able to deliver a perfectly acceptable presentation.
Multilingualism can thus be essential for democracy to work properly. But the Parliament's translation service can't cover all meetings. As Jeremy Dessel, a newly elected French MEP, learned to his cost at his first encounter with his colleagues in the Parliament's Liberal grouping.
Oh, Dacian, comment ça va?
La réunion n'était pas...
The meeting wasn't translated. There were just 7 or 8 of us. Everyone was speaking English, and I was the only one there who wasn't able to speak or understand the language. So you see, it's not easy.
Since taking up his seat, the young politician has also taken up English lessons. But the language actually spoken in Brussels is often referred to as globish, a sort of simplified English that people of different nationalities can understand. And things are likely to get worse. Brexit could mean the departure of a large proportion of those civil servants and MEPs who are native English speakers. In fact, English may soon disappear from the Union's list of official languages. According to the treaties, Malta's language is Maltese and Ireland's is Gaelic.
It might seem a bit strange if the European Union chooses as its main language one that isn't among its official languages for work and external communication. And it leaves a huge amount of influence to an Anglo-American culture, which, not from my point of view, but from an economic one, risks becoming an enemy.
France's president Emmanuel Macron agrees. He's made it clear he hopes speaking French will soon once again be de rigueur in Brussels.